believe we're good for you to count down.
Okay, so it'll be when I select the actual game mode and then timer stops on the last hit of the Pirate Master.
Alright, so if you can just count down and then tell me time, we'll be good.
Alright, so we will start in 3, 2, 1, go. Hello everyone, my name is JT Norimaki, and this is Shantae and the Pirate's Curse. If anyone is familiar with this game, this is the third in the Shantae series that came out originally on 3DS and imported to Wii U, recently out on Xbox and PS4. And we're going to pick up right where the second game left off. Our hero has been stripped of her magic powers, so now she has to make do with everything, but because we're doing this in pirate mode, we have a lot of weapons at our disposal and we're going to make use of them, so hang on, this is going to be a pretty quick ride. First things first, we gotta battle all these soldiers that are invading our hometown, which is never good. Thanks for the good luck, Silo, by the way. Alright, so the saber bounce basically penetrates floors, as you can tell, and then we are going to see our friends, but we don't care what they have to say, so we skip their text box right there with a simple jump. They could just kind of chill out and do whatever they want to do, that's fine. It's not bad RNG getting a pike ball there, though I'll take that any day. Alright, RNG boss number one, the Ammo Baron. He can either treat you very well or very bad. And right now he's going to treat us bad. So, we're going to taunt him. Okay, that's not so bad now. Sometimes he can do up to 4 charges of that tank, and it gets really annoying, eats up a ton of time. But, as you can tell, this boss is pretty much set and done, so GG Ammo Baron, we'll see you next time. Now Shantae, being happy and bubbly, is super happy to be going to court. Aren't we all, whenever we get a court summons? So after a hard day of battling, what's the best thing to do when you're done? You go home, you take a bath. But the problem is, you realize, you don't actually own a bath. Oopsie. Then you get that feeling when your arch nemesis has been peeking on you the whole time. Good crackle bat fight. See you. Risky then gives you back the magic lamp that was from the, it was basically the main plot point of the second game. So that was nice of her to give us the one thing that she tried so hard to kill us with in the first game. It was so great. Alright, so what's the best way to break house arrest? Well, first you go visit your best friend for a library card. Go visit the save guy for a mandatory save. This game unfortunately requires you to take or you go nowhere. And And then just tell the guard at the beginning of the town to say, you know, I just want to go get a book because I'm under house arrest. And you're free. And I wish I was making up some of this stuff. A lot of these story points that I'll be pointing out throughout the game are part of the story. It's exactly what you get with this game, so... Unfortunately, I didn't get any good RNG there. Usually you can get a good drop that you need later in the run for that, but oh well. We'll just keep going anyway. And now we're going to run into an old friend of ours, the Squid Baron, who's got a little bit of post-game ennui. He has this bad feeling that he's just going to be nothing more than a filler boss. Okay, snakes are starting to give it. There's a 50% chance drop of these, and I need as much food as possible out of this segment. So what I'm going to be using is the saber bounce in tight spaces as a glitch to kind of take advantage of a lingering hitbox. Get off the chain, girl. There you go. And I need as many pieces of food as I can get just to make sure that we can do a lot of the skips that we'll need to get through the run. Okay, it's not terrible. I ended up with... Okay, I maxed out on food. That's good. This run's intact. The bird in the furnace, yes. Okay, so we run into our friend Bolo here, who basically is being hounded by a bunch of zombie kids. Part of the reason we need the food from the sewers was so that he could make sure that they don't eat him alive. And this brochure goes back to Squid Baron, who now is off to a tropical paradise for a vacation at our behest, so... We then use this key to open the palace, which was installed by... The lock was installed by our friend, and the funny part about that is he's a complete idiot, so... He installed it inside out, upside down, and backwards, and they couldn't figure out how to open it without that key. So, yep, we're in there. This old man is going to bury our summons in red tape. Gotta love how government works. And then we continue on. So, not a lot to say about this part. We're just going to be charging back to town. And we'll hope for a little bit better RNG here. Doesn't look like I'm going to get it. Alright, I got another pipe ball. I guess it's okay. It's not perfect, but we'll take it. But one important lesson, everyone, is when you borrow things, make sure you return it because, you get money for it. So, thanks for the $100. Bye. We're out. Do a little bit of shopping. Okay. Now we go on our grand adventure. Welcome to wonderful Saliva Island. Saliva Island has a very tragic story.
Let's go.
But of course, being the speedrun, we don't care. We'll just see our old man here. And this old man. It's good to see you, whatever. I see you got a girl there that, dang it, glitch, come on. I see you got a girl there that's in stone, but whatever. In honesty, that was probably the biggest piece of mercy that we could have done because you actually end up killing that guy if you actually go through it all, so... It's for the best that we just skip that guy anyway. Alright, I'm going to take a marathon safety save here because this trick is a pain. Got it. Nice. That feel when you can just skip an entire dungeon practically because of the gear that you have. And how's this for jiggle physics? Bouncy, 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 bouncy. It's a good old pogo strats right here. You could technically skip that room. It's a real difficult trick, though. In a world record attempt, you certainly would be going for that. And we've made our first boss. So let's see what happens here. And first boss down. Just kidding. Oh wow, that was bad. Okay. Okay, this boss and I are not getting along today. There we go. So you'll notice that just about everything in this game explodes. It's basically said that the bosons are the Michael Bay of video game making. It was not a great fight, but we got through it, we're fine. So then we find these Tinkerbats, which are the actual real minions of our nemesis Risky Boots. They seem to be giving us clues and hints. Again, old man, live a long and fruitful life. Enjoy. And now we're off to scenic Spiderweb Island, where some of the best stuff in this entire speedrun happens. The only reason to really run this game. Pulled by ghosts there. That can happen sometimes. Stop and grab this fossil. It'll be very important later in the run. And what you're seeing there with me going back and forth really quick in order to build up the charge is what we call the Risky Shuffle. It can be pulled off with any controller that has an analog and a D-pad. Just by alternating directions, it keeps your momentum. And now enter Roddy Tops, our zombie friend who is being molested by a spider, but we'll save her from that gruesome fate, only to be thrust into probably the most questionable and fanservice-y part of the game. Run, run, Roddy Tops is the main reason everybody speedruns this game. And that is a huge kappa after that, by the way. Huge kappa. Normally, we take bets on any speedrun about how many deaths occur during this segment. It's actually a good first room right there. Skipping all of those tongues definitely helps. Nice. Got all four of the big skips there. Now, normally, that throws off the global cycle timer of these spikes, which are very reminiscent of Super Mario Bros. 3. Anyone remembers those? A few throwbacks to a lot of different games in this particular one, so enjoy some of the nostalgia. And the best sprite work possible if somebody ants you to get through something as quickly as possible. Look at that, she's gotta go to the bathroom. Come on, let's hurry. Ooh, that was close. But we made it. Wow, the one time I don't trust them, they actually don't move. These gravestones move purely on RNG, which is a real pain to deal with. And they have the propensity to basically ruin your day or your run whenever they want to, so. And if you take a really close look at these robots, you can tell that they are chasing Shantae down just to give her a big juicy smooch. Robots need love too. But we don't want any of that, so see you guys. Alright, so coming up here very shortly is probably the most questionable monster in the entire segment. A lot of interesting names have been placed on these puppies. Just don't worry about it, they're all ghost snakes and they're just shooting little baby ghost snakes and they don't look like anything else at all, so. And the gates of hell were closed, oh well. Aha, he tried for the quick cycle, I wasn't having it. So this is pretty much the last room where they throw everything you've seen at you all at the same time. Can also be the most punishing if you take a death in that last segment there, you have to start that room all over again, so that's okay. That was an absolutely perfect run ruddy tops. And we avoid the cackle bat of shame that if anyone actually dies there in a serious attempt, we laugh at them pretty hard, so. We will take a deathless and perfect run and get the heck out of Dodge. We've returned Roddy to her brother. And on we go. So we give Squid Oil, which apparently is extremely useful for repairing completely shattered wagon wheels. Don't ask why. Apparently that stuff is pretty sticky. But are now completely able to circumvent that force from hell. So there's always a gut. And also, little boys, remember, wash your shriveled things, or it'll smell. And you can't have that now, can you? But of course, if you do have one, you can feed it to a dungeon, so it opens its door. It's always a beautiful thing. Bad. It's alright though, we'll get through it. Alright, next trick that you'll see because of the risky shuffle is something we call food floating in this game. Allows for some big time sequence breaks. Or, as we call it, eating the food that sends us to the infinite and beyond. Even though we have been stripped of our magical powers, Shantae, being the half-genie she is, can still fly, let's just put it that way. So, at any rate, we are on to our next boss. And RNG willing, thank goodness I actually got in Monster Milk for this fight, which we normally don't have, so that's a beautiful thing. This should make this fight a lot easier. It's not one of the easier bosses in the game, but if you don't like spoopy spiders, then I'd recommend you turn away now. Oh my goodness. I might employ a few hitbox strats with this spider just to keep the damage rolling. Main thing is just not to die, or let her get the flames off if we can avoid it. There we go. It's not a terrible fight, no worries. Big spoopy spider down. And we're gonna get the next map from our good pal, the Tinkerbats. Or same one, not really explained whether it's multiple or just one. That's right, Shantae. Now we're off to sunny Tanline Island, which is not appropriately named because we do not get to see any real tan lines, but we hope. And Shantae just called the run for us by saying "Ret to go." That's the call. RNG willing, I can get a bubble here, but it does not look like it's going to do that for me, so. Maybe we'll get some super pike balls here. Never lucky. Never lucky. This is gonna quickly turn into what I call a famine run, where you're basically under-equipped and under-geared. Alright, good news, I got three super pike balls on the way out, so. Famine run averted. We're good, we're good. Hopefully I don't screw this up, or otherwise we're going to lose a ton of time here. Actually, I'm going to take this marathon safe here. Or not. Forget it's 2-3 cannon bursts. So that's unfortunate. I'm going to have to take an extra shopping trip here in a second just to get an extra potion. Oh, dang it. But I'm gonna come up to the hardest boss in the game here very shortly. The purple block of doom. Okay, that wasn't terrible. Gotta do some slight farming here, so we're gonna go back and forth a little bit. The Scorp Gals have 25% chance to drop either a Super Pike Ball or a Super Monster Milk. We need some Super Monster Milks just for boss ease for the latter part of the run, and right now, she's not being very cooperative. Nothing new here. But it's no worries. We're gonna go at it until we get what we need. Hopefully. I think she was mad that I killed the one out of, after the purple block. All the super pike balls in the world. I'm good there, lady. Let's go. Wow. This is really bad RNG right now. I may have to do the poor man's route and not have the buffs, but I would at least like one. If I can at least get one, we'll move on. Alright, I'm only gonna give this two more attempts and then we're gonna move forward. Wow. One more. Alright, well, no monster milk for us. And that will happen in a run occasionally, unfortunately. It's just a thing, we're just gonna have to deal with it. I might be able to buy some later. Or we can get some monster milk drops here, if we're lucky. Okay, that's fortunate. That's really fortunate. Okay, so that's where they were hiding this run. Alright, so we find out that Shantae's butt wiggles have an actual use. Oh, I did that too soon. Alright. Well, slow route. You can get this crusher in one cycle with a perfectly timed risky shuffle and charge. It's a beautiful thing when it happens. I had just barely missed it when she banged her forehead there, but that's okay. Alright. And guess who's our mid-boss? Hey, check him out. He was right. This fight could get really messy very quick because of the fact that I do not have a monster milk in my favor. Because ideally you want to beat him before he gets into this eating phase, so that the second phase he just goes right into that, but now we're going to have to deal with the ugly pattern of him, but that's fine. So we have an upgrade, he's got a metal suit. Had a metal suit. And now we play jump rope. There we go. Unfortunately, I lost my auto potion, but that's fine. The good news is I've got plenty of food for the remainder of the run anyway, so that auto potion is not necessary, it's just nice to have. For two bosses later in the run, we'll do without. This is gonna be the famine run based on everything else that's happened here, so we'll adjust accordingly and move forward. Oh, yeah. Flare activated. Alright, so our next stop is supposed to be Mudbog Island, but we gotta make a slight detour here. We check out our friend Bolo, who suddenly fancies himself a scientist. The guy seems to just be a master, like a jack of all trades, not even close to being a master of any. But given a fossil and some X-ray specs, he's able to identify an ancient fossil to be a mask. And we're gonna use that. Okay, again, we're gonna do some shopping real quick. And with my 50... we'll buy one monster milk. Oh, I needed an extra potion too, but that's fine, I'll get it in a minute. We'll buy the extra potion as soon as we're done here with this island. Let's go! So this is where the difficulty spike of the game kicks in. The damage values of these monsters heats up really quick, but if you know how to get through here, navigate just fine, especially in this mode, you can get through it pretty safely. We were gonna get stopped in this room anyway, so taking that stop there is not a bad idea. And it just looks really smooth when you're able to not do that. For some reason my cannon didn't want to fire, but normally it looks extremely smooth. Yes, you may have the mask. And we're now in the Village of Lost Souls, or basically hell, I guess if that's what you want to call it. And for now, we're just going to be collecting coins. Why, you ask? For the biggest game of RNG in your life. It's alright, though. Lack of ghost troll. It's a good thing. Ran out of space though. Actually really good to get through that room without taking a single thing. Those guys appear at random, pure RNG on that. So, not bad to get through that. Alright, so now we gotta play a game of heads or tails with these three guys. You literally could just do the whole guessing game with these guys, but WayForward did plan in a kind of contingency where if you lose three times, whatever your next guesses are on the next set will always be right, so we just mash heads on all three of the gamers in order to get through that as quickly as possible. And then you might recognize this girl, only less green. We call her Healthy Tops. Light a bonfire, and a mysterious man in black shows up to give us Old Spice. We now smell like the man that you could smell like. But we need it in this dungeon because they will not let any flowery, smelly girls in, so gotta smell as manly and musky as possible. But you can't fool everybody, because even the guys in the background here are like, oh my god, who let in the good smelling girl? Look at those WTF faces, boys. Power, exactly. Exactly, chat. Oh, wow. It's pretty bad. Risky shuffle wouldn't fire. There we go. Okay, I'm lucky he didn't just spout at me. I got away with one there. I know what that YouTube link's for, guys. That's pretty funny. Ooh, I should have taken a save there. We could have a problem. No, we'll be fine. I should have taken a save here. This guy can wreck runs. He's not full RNG, but he has his moments, so... Focus for this guy. Just to be safe. Just to be really safe, because he's gonna wreck me here shortly. There we go. Whew, got through him. I did not want to die there. That was way, way too much food usage, though, so we may have to rely on some backup strats on that as well. No biggie. Alright, so we picked up a lost soul. And we are done with that nightmare. So we got the map for Frostbite Island. We are going to take a slight detour so I can restock the one potion that I need for the run. And if we're lucky, one of these wolves might drop me something special, but I doubt it. Because that would be, you know, lucky, and we don't get that in the speedrun. And the fact that we basically try to avoid him anyway, so it doesn't matter. Oh, wow. And we skip pretty much this entire place just by doing that one little trick. It's a beautiful thing. Take the damage to get through here, and We run into Bolo again, who now fancies himself yet another scientist. And is making target modules for the bad guys. What an idiot. Yo, Mad Test, thanks, man. Alright, so we gotta return here really quick. Fortunately, we don't have to go through that nightmare that was called Run Run Ruddy Tops. Hey, don't say it's saved yet, guys. There's a lot of game left. Not really, it's not that much left. We're getting very close to being done here, actually. We're now on a collection to go ahead and get things opened up. First, we gotta give over the lost soul to who would know best but the zombies, of course. To find out, it's the spirit of Joe. Who the heck is Joe, you ask? Well, in this particular speedrun, you don't necessarily find out until you actually have to revive him. Two pieces of food. I believe that is everything I'm gonna need for the run. I am just gonna hope that maybe one of these guys will drop me a lobster tail, but that's asking way too much from an RNG perspective. I get an extra pike ball, I guess, but that doesn't really do me any good since I've got plenty of super pike balls. Maybe I can get a bento box here. Alright, we're gonna do a backup really quick. I just want to get a couple of pieces of safety food here, just in case. So, bear with about 2 seconds. Okay, I'll take the one. It's fine, I won't get greedy. So, there's this interesting fellow who's been looking for his sword. We're gonna give it to him. And when he holds it off, he says, "Hey guys, we should get matching purses. No reason they should just be for ladies anymore. Am I right, fellas? Don't run." Yes, that's right. And now he's not He-Man. Flare activated. I just had to show that off. Could have skipped that entire text, but that's okay. So our friend Joe is here. Turned to stone. I still say the bird did it. He looks a little shifty. Overprotective of his master, possibly. Mr. Techno Baron is still flying as far as we know. He's never returned. Probably floating around in orbit somewhere, that's fine. The abandoned factory. We're gonna take a quick safety save here because if this skip misses, we lose all that time. We don't want that. Got it. Nice. So we just basically skipped that entire dungeon by doing that. Here we go. RNG Maggot. He's got these nice red buttons that are in random order in order to make him vulnerable to attack, and we've got a really nasty pattern today. I cannot get it. I'll just take it slow now. Got my buffs off a little late there, but that's okay. In before 1, 2, 3. Nope. 1, 3, 2. Wow. Oh wow, am I really going 4-cycle in this guy? It's pretty bad. It's not a good fight. Why is this guy not dying? Wow. Way to go, Maggot. Oh, dang it, I know that. I just did it, dummy. All right, come on now. Jeez, he has one hit left. Are you kidding me? Oh, well. Way to go, RNG Maggot. Run killer extraordinaire. So we're coming up on the final stretch here. We are almost done. Only one really important thing to do is charge in. Charge in. And, oh, there's really nothing going on here. Surprise. Or is there? Oh, spoopy ghost. Well, that just happened. Hope we know how to drive a boat. Guess we do. But things do not look happy in Scuttletown. Ooh, almost got the Heart of Shame. That in this run, it's any percent pirate. We don't care about upgrades. So things are not happy in the palace, not at all. But this was Shantae's face when everyone realized that we could do this to skip all of the trials here. This is a series of rooms that put all your skills with the weapons that you've collected throughout the run to the test. And they're not fun. They're not fun at all. Alright, because of the fact that we're in a bit of a buff issue problem with Pirate Master, we're going to do this. Just to be safe. And charge into the final battle. The reason for the jumps here is because it does give a, just like an extra hit when you do it. die. Time's coming up. Egg time.
All right. You had a 49.56.
It's not terrible. I'll take a sub 50.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
There was a lot of backup strats in that run, but I'll take it and run with it, so. And now we'll get the unsatisfying bad ending. But thank you very much, guys. Hope you enjoyed.
Yeah. Are you keeping it up for an ending, or is it good to switch over?
Yeah, the only thing we look at is the in-game time. It doesn't really matter. It's just slightly manipulable, but it's not what we rank on, so it doesn't really matter. You guys can go ahead and switch over if you'd like.
I mean, we're pretty far out of time, so...
Yeah, this run was way, way overestimated, so it's no biggie.
Yeah. How long does it usually take?
Normal, it's about 45 minutes.
Alright, how long does it take to get to the time or whatever?
Oh, I'm fast-forwarding. We're almost there now.
Okay.
So, 45-57 in-game is not bad. Alright. Anyway, that was Shantae and the Pirate's Curse.